Welcome all. This is Dr. T. Jani Shiva, Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. This is the second video under the title Water and its Treatment. And today's topic is boiler feed water and boiler troubles. Let us go into the topic. So after completing this topic, you will be able to outline the boiler feed water requirements, and also you will be able to discuss the boiler related problems, especially the problems related to hardness of water. So before entering into the topic, we should know what is a boiler. A boiler is a device for generating steam, and it consists of two parts, the furnace and the boiler proper. The furnace provides heat usually by burning a fuel, and the boiler proper is a device in which heat changes into steam. As steam is produced, dissolved solids become concentrated and form deposits inside the boiler. This leads to poor heat transfer and reduces the efficiency of the boiler. Hence, proper treatment of boiler feed water is an important part in operating and maintaining a boiler system. Now let us go into the concept of boiler feed water. The water which is fed into the boiler for the production of steam is called boiler feed water. To say more about boiler feed water, the water which undergoes purification or preheating and then supplied to boilers for hot water and steam production is also termed as feed water. And it should have the following composition. Its hardness should be below 0.2 parts per million, and its soda alkalinity, which is caused due to the presence of sodium carbonate, should be 0.45 to 1 parts per million. It also should be free from dissolved gases, turbidity, oil and grease, etc. Suppose if these are present, let us assume that hardness exceeding 0.2 ppm, soda alkalinity greater than 1 ppm, and if the water contains dissolved gases, turbidity, oil and grease, it may lead to certain boiler troubles or troubles inside the boiler, which are termed as boiler problems or boiler troubles. Now let us see about the various boiler troubles which are caused due to the presence of hardness producing salts, or due to the presence of sodium carbonate, or due to the presence of grease, oil, turbidity, etc. The five basic boiler problems are priming, foaming, carryover, scaling, corrosion. So among these five, we are going to concentrate on scaling along with sludge formation. This scaling can be otherwise known as scale formation. Why we are concentrating on scaling? Because this scale formation is due to the presence of hardness producing salts inside the boiler. Now let us see about what is scaling or scale formation. So what is a scale? A scale is a hard deposit which is formed over the metal surface of a boiler. These scales are nothing but the salts of calcium and magnesium salts, which are existing primarily in the form of sulfates or carbonates, which are highly insoluble in water. As they are highly insoluble in water, when the water inside the boiler boils or is converted into steam, these salts, they get precipitated and they get adhered to the surface of the boiler, forming hard deposits. Now in this picture you can see the presence of scales inside the boiler surface. Now what are the problems caused due to the scale formation or scaling? So this scaling decreases the efficiency of a boiler, as the dissolved salts and solid particles having chances of getting carried away into the turbine blades and finally getting deposited over the blades. And the lifetime of the different parts of the boiler subjected to scaling is at stake. Judgment of actual height of the water column also becomes difficult, making maintenance procedure quite troublesome, and carryover poses a serious problem to the parts such as the turbine blades, steam traps, valve bodies, etc. So these are some of the problems. And how to overcome these problems? So let us see to the solution for the scaling. So first one is, we have to ensure proper feed water treatment, and also we have to go for an expert advice of a chemist regarding the boiler and feed water treatment, and we have to maintain lower water levels, and the main steam stop valve should be opened very gradually, and the leakage of any foreign material into the boiler feed water system should be avoided. So the initial stage, if we are able to find out the presence of scales inside the boiler, we may remove it by acid washing or using a wire brush or a scrubber or by using thermal shocks. So these are some of the removal methods. The next one is the sludge formation, which is a very similar problem like scaling. So what are sludges? Sludges are loose and slimy precipitates which are floating on the surface of water. What is the difference between this sludges and scales? Scales, they stick on to the inner surface of the boiler, but these sludges, they will be floating on the surface of water. So this is the only difference. And these sludges are formed due to the presence of calcium chloride, magnesium carbonate and magnesium chloride. And this image shows the floating of sludges on the surface of water inside the boiler. Now what are the problems? The same problems like scaling, they reduce the efficiency of the boiler, and also these sludges are poor conductors, so there is wastage of fuel. How to overcome this problem? The solution is, we have to directly use soft water, or we have to go for frequent blow down operation. What is frequent blow down operation? It is nothing but the removal of the salt concentrated water by opening the valve. After completion of this course, I think you all can answer these questions. What is boiler feed water? Give its requirements. Explain in detail about scale and sludge formation, its effects and removal methods. I hope you all enjoyed this video and understood the concept of scale and sludge formation. This is due to the presence of hardness producing salts inside the boiler. Thank you for listening.